First of all, welcome you all in my class. So student, today we are going to study about osteoporosis. It is also comes under to musculoskeletal disorder. So let's go, we will start our today's class. What is it? It means, what is osteoporosis? Metabolic skeletal disease characterized by low bone density and microarchitectural deterioration of the bone tissue, which results in increased bone fragility and susceptibility to fracture. So if we think about the osteoporosis, so if we think a single words of osteoporosis, it means low bone density. Okay, it is called osteoporosis. And what is the density, student? Density means the degree of competence of a substance, means measure of amount of information on its store medium is very low. So it is called density, and that particular process is very low in a duration of osteoporosis. So it is called osteoporosis condition. Okay. And as well as deterioration also happen in duration of the osteoporosis. So what is deterioration? Means the process of becoming progressively worse if person is suffering by osteoporosis, and that osteoporosis condition is day by day very increased. So what is the actual condition? One day definitely progressive condition is very worst. Okay, so it is called deterioration. And then after, what thing is actually result happen after the osteoporosis? Increased bone fragility. Means, what is the meaning of fragility, student? Fragility is the quality of being easily broken or damaged just because of low bone density is a day by day increasing. That condition definitely one day's result happen, that result is fragility, means easily bone broken. Okay, broken. So it is called osteoporosis condition. Now we will see next thing related to osteoporosis. Pathophysiology about osteoporosis. So first thing is very important reason for osteoporosis. That reason is the bone remodeling. Okay, so here have some points related to bone remodeling. Before going to points of bone remodeling, firstly we just think and we just learn about what is remodeling. So remodeling, student, bone remodeling is a lifelong process. Okay, where mature bone tissue is removed from skeleton and new bone tissue is formed, it is called remodeling of the bone. So that particular process and that particular thing is altered in a duration of osteoporosis just because of density of happen. Okay, then after this thing we will see some points related to bone remodeling. Bone remodeling occurs throughout an individual lifetime. It is because it is a lifeline process, an individual lifetime process, that's why. And then after the normal adults, the activity of osteoclast, means bone reabsorption, is balanced by that of osteoblast bone formation. Okay, normal bone remodeling in the adult results in gradually increased bone mass until the early 32nd. Okay, so how many time is needed for the bone remodeling? That particular time is early stage of the 32nd for the process of bone remodeling. So that particular process of bone remodeling is firstly altered before happen the osteoporosis. Okay, just because of due to any kind of the causes. Then further, what thing is happen? Calcitonin is happen, which inhibit bone reabsorption, promote bone formation decrease just because of the calcitonin is altered. That's why decrease bone formation process. Then after further, which lead to the estrogen is responsible, which inhibit the bone breakdown. Okay, then further last we will further which lead to PTH, increased bone turnover and reabsorption increase. Means parathyroid hormone is also altered just because of alteration of estrogen hormone. Then further, which lead to the, if parathyroid hormone is alteration in particular condition of the process and that physiology of osteoporosis, so what thing is happen? The thing is the increased bone turnover reabsorption, means reabsorption of bone turnover is a very increased just because of the that particular thing is the alteration calcitonin thing, estrogen thing, and as well as alteration of the PTH hormone. Okay, so then after person maybe they have a chance to osteoporosis condition. So basically here four thing is very important step is a current duration of osteoporosis. First thing is a bone remodeling condition, then after what thing is altered, calcitonin altered, and then after estrogen also altered, and then lastly PTH hormone is very responsible factor for the leading condition of osteoporosis. Okay student, so it is a pathophysiology related to the osteoporosis. I hope you all are understand. Now we will see next thing related to osteoporosis. Here have some risk factor related to osteoporosis. So first risk is female more than male. It is very clear because female is very somewhere female is weak and female bone is also body structure is also weak as compared to male. So that's why it is a very very clear thing for the risk of the osteoporosis. Then increase age, because why increase age? Because we all are know day by day age is increased. So if person is increase of day increase of age, that condition that person system is also weakened. Okay, so here musculoskeletal system is also weaker just because of increasing of age. So that condition person also risk for the density also weak, okay, or low. So that's why it is also one kind of risk factor for the osteoporosis. Then inadequate intake of calcium and vitamin D. A person is not proper taking vitamin D and calcium, so that condition inadequate is happen and deficiency of happen. Which kind of deficiency? Calcium deficiency and vitamin D. So both thing is very very important substance for maintain the strongness of bone. That's why a person not proper taking that condition, that person also have a risk for the osteoporosis. Okay, now estrogen deficiency or menopause. So we all are know, we already seen in a pathophysiology student, estrogen hormone is also one kind of responsible for the breakdown of bone just because of alteration of estrogen hormone. So here it is also one kind of responsible factor for osteoporosis. Okay, then family history, if have any kind of family history means historic means hereditary factor. Okay, lack of the physical activity, if anyone is not proper maintaining physical activity, so that particular person bone is not proper, and not only bone and all kind of musculoskeletal system is also weak. So that condition that person bone is also weakened, and then after maybe the chances density also leading condition. Okay, now the next is smoking, alcohol consumption. So both thing is a very very important risk factor not only for the osteoporosis as well as another kind of also diseases occur just because of taking smoking and alcohol consumption. So both thing is a very very risk factor. Okay, now medication, some medication also responsible like corticosteroid, anti-seizure medicine. So after the very long time taking corticosteroid and anti-seizure, that condition that particular medicine is showing side effect, and which kind of side effect? Bone or musculoskeletal system side effect. It is called osteoporosis, means that medicine is have a risk for the weaken of the bone. Okay, now next cause and risk factor for osteoporosis is low weight and body mass index. So if person have a very low weight, that condition that particular person bone is not proper protected, so maybe the chances that person have a very risk for the fracture and any kind of trauma. So that condition that person bone is also very weaker after day by day happen that particular risk. So it is also one kind of risk factor for osteoporosis. Okay, now Caucasian and Asian also very important kind of risk factor for the condition of osteoporosis. So this all are a risk factor student for the condition of osteoporosis. Now we will see next thing about osteoporosis. So next thing is sign and symptoms related to osteoporosis. Osteoporosis has been called silent disease because bone mass is lost over many years with no sign or symptoms. So osteoporosis second name is silent disease. Why it is called silent disease? Because osteoporosis is not showing initial period of signs and symptoms, and many are also not showing any kind of symptoms related to osteoporosis. That's why it is called to silent disease. Okay, so here have some symptoms, signs and symptoms. Like first is loss of height. Because why loss of height is happened by the osteoporosis? Because weakening of and density is happen. That's why bone is not proper development and growth. So height is also altered just because of osteoporosis. Now second thing is back pain. If person is affect spine bone or maybe the chances is pelvic bone, so that condition that person have a chance, and vertebral bone, so that condition that person definitely feel sensation of back pain and weaker of the bone. So that's why person definitely feel the pain sensation in the side of back. Okay, now the next symptom is vertebra collapse. What is collapse? Collapse means stop. So if person is affect very long time backbone osteoporosis, that condition that particular backbone is one day definitely stop and alter the function. So if anything and any organ is stop functioning, that particular thing is comes under to collapse condition, an alteration of normal function. So it is condition is a collapse. So if person affect by osteoporosis, and basically that condition osteoporosis affect in the vertebra bone, so that particular situation that person showing vertebra collapse. Okay, and vertebra collapse, it is also called Dogray's hub. So it is related to osteoporosis sign and symptoms. Now we will see some diagnostic evaluation, how we can diagnose and how we can detect to osteoporosis. So here have some diagnostic tool. First is X-ray studies. X-ray is very initial and very necessary study for detect the patient related to osteoporosis. So what we monitor by the X-ray study? Determine bone density. Okay, by the X-ray study. Now radiographics, bone mass, osteopenia, how much the bone destroy and breakdowning and loss by the osteoporosis, we just detect by the radiographic bone masses. Okay, now ultrasonography. By the ultrasonography, what thing is we detect? Determine bone density also. So by the ultrasonography, it is also one kind of important diagnostic tool for detect the case of density level related to osteoporosis situation. Okay, now the dual energy X-ray absorptiometric. So is the perform modality for measuring bone mineral density. Bone mineral density means very minorest and very mineral part of density happen, that particular thing is we detect by the DXA. Okay, so it is also one kind of a radiographic techniques for detecting the patient related to osteoporosis. And which kind of density we just monitor by the dual energy X-ray reabsorptiometric test? Mineral density. Okay, person is occurred by mineral density, that condition we just perform that kind of investigation tool. So this all are very important kind of tool for the condition of osteoporosis. And diagnostic tool, another diagnostic evaluation also available for the condition of osteoporosis. Like you all are know already, physical examination, history taking is very initial or necessary condition for diagnostic evaluation tool. And then if we are not capable to diagnose and if we are not proper detect the patient related to osteoporosis by the X-ray, so that condition we perform MRI in CT scan. Okay students, so that all kind of investigation tool is very important tool for detect the patient related to osteoporosis. Now we will see next thing related to osteoporosis.
management therapy. So first management therapy is drug therapy. So here have some different kind of drug for the treatment of case related to musculoskeletal. It is called osteoporosis. So first medicine is calcitonin. Calcitonin are synthetic thyroid hormone usually prescribed as a daily nasal spray to reduce factors that cause loss of calcium and increase reabsorption of calcium in the gastrointestinal tract. So calcitonin is a help for promote the level of calcium, and we all are know student, calcium is a very important major substance for the maintain strongness and strength of the bone. So that's why we are providing calcitonin medicine. Now second medicine is selective estrogen receptor modulator, means estrogen receptor medicine. Why estrogen receptor medicine? Because we all are know, if a person is suffer by estrogen hormone alteration, that condition, that person also have a risk for the which condition? Osteoporosis. That's why we are providing estrogen receptor medicine also in a condition of osteoporosis. Okay, now next thing is hormone replacement therapy to increase serous estrogen level, which is turn decrease the rate of bone reabsorption. Okay, so that's why it is also very very important kind of drug therapy, hormone replacement therapy for the treatment of the osteoporosis condition, just because of decreased rate of bone reabsorption process. Okay, if we are providing hormone replacement therapy, that condition, that person definitely preventing the decreased rate of bone reabsorption, and that if any person is suffered by the osteoporosis and that person maintaining the bone reabsorption rate, that condition definitely that person density level is also improve. Okay, so that's why we are providing hormone replacement therapy. So it is related to drug therapy. Now we will see next thing or another treatment therapy for osteoporosis. Non-pharmacological treatment also available for the condition of osteoporosis, like diet changes. Okay, so diet changes is very very important kind of non-pharmacological therapy for the condition of osteoporosis. So which kind of diet is very important? Calcium contribute diet, dairy product like milk, yogurt, cheese, ice cream, cottage cheese, and the fortified origin juice or the soya products. So calcium contributor diet is very very important diet, and most vitamin D comes diet is also very important helpful therapy for the treatment of osteoporosis. Okay, next thing, fruits and vegetable containing magnesium is essential for healthy bones, because you all are know students, magnesium is a very essential substance for maintaining the healthy bone. So that's why we are providing an encouraged patient to take proper magnesium diet, and patient should be educated to avoid consuming excessive amount of vitamin A. It have the increased risk for fracture in both men and women. So a person is suffer by osteoporosis, so that condition we encourage the patient to avoid excessive amount of vitamin A, just because of preventing of risk related to fracture. Okay, now vitamin C influence collagen production and increase osteoblast formation and survival. Moderate protein intake is recommended, and caffeine in hypophosphatemia decrease the BMD. Okay, so this kind of dietary and this kind of non-pharmacological therapy is very very important therapy for the maintaining of bone function, bone strongness, bone strength, healthy bone, etc. Okay students, so it is also comes under to treatment therapy. Now we will see nursing diagnosis and nursing management related to osteoporosis. So first nursing diagnosis is acute pain, just because of weaker of bone and density of the bone, impaired physical mobility, self-care deficit, decreasing dressing or the groaning, imbalanced nutrition, less than body requirement, risk for impaired skin integrity, risk for injury also happen, risk for constipation related to immobility, deficient knowledge about the osteoporosis process and treatment regimen. So this kind of nursing diagnosis comes under to osteoporosis condition. A person is suffer related to problem of osteoporosis, so that condition, that problem is definitely have a risk. So if person is suffer that particular problem, what we do? So here have some intervention for the maintaining of nursing diagnosis or treatment of nursing diagnosis. First, the intervention is consumes adequate dietary calcium and vitamin D for the maintain of healthy bone and a strong provide of the bone. Increase to increase level of exercise for maintaining the mobility process. Okay, modify lifestyle choices, avoid smoking, alcohol, carbonates beverages, just because of the prevention of density level. Maintain optimal body weight. Okay, because we all are know less body weight is also one kind of risk factor, that's why we maintain optimal body weight. Create safe home environment and adherence to prescribed screening and monitoring procedure for the preventing of further complication. Take prescribed medication as instruction for the proper treatment and level of prognosis for the improvement. So take prescribed medication properly related patient of osteoporosis. Okay, so this kind of intervention is very very important intervention for the condition of osteoporosis. Okay students, so it's related to osteoporosis topic. So here our topic is completed. So I hope you all are understand about today's class related to osteoporosis, and thank you for listening me. If you have any doubts, so please ask me.